Good morning from the North Pole, or at least it looks like it, as we've got a winter wonderland out there today, so you're gonna need to give yourselves a little extra time to get to work. And to help you on your way, here's a Christmas classic.
Dashing through the snow in a one-horse open sleigh, o'er the fields we go, laughing all the way. Bells on bobtail ring, making spirits bright. What fun it is to ride and sing a sleighing song tonight. Oh, jingle bells, jingle bells, jingle all the way.
Holly, you are a lifesaver. I didn't have the
time, I know.
You have an excuse. It's not every day you get to meet the founder of the company you work for.
Speaking of that, what do you think of this outfit?
Turn. I like it. It says Christina Masters is professional but approachable.
Oh, I just hope Victoria McDougal does too. Oh, I really want to make a good first impression.
Then we're gonna have to get rid of that.
Thank you.
And you've got nothing to worry about. You've been doing an amazing job managing the store.
With a little help from the best assistant manager in town.
How are your plans for the Christmas display coming along?
They're coming along.
Well, I hope it's better than last year's.
Last year's was great. We had live calling birds, turtle doves, French hens from France.
And it almost took us 3 weeks before we got the smell out of the place.
Oh, that.
Somebody who goes all out decorating her store for Christmas. I see a distinct lack of ho-ho-ho in here.
Oh, I don't have time for all that. Besides, I get all the Christmas I need at McDougal's.
Come on, that's not the same. That's a business thing.
Christmas is business, Holly. Good business. That's why they call it the most wonderful time of the year.
So tell me, have you made your plans for Christmas yet?
No. My mom and dad decided to take an African safari for the holidays. My brother and his kids are spending it with his wife's family.
Ooh, why don't you come have Christmas with us? My mom would love to see you.
That's so sweet. Thank you. But I don't think so.
My cousin Peter's going to be there. Remember I told you about him?
Yeah, and remember I told you I'm not interested?
Come on, you work 70-hour weeks. You never take a vacation. When was the last time you even went on a date?
What can I say? I'm in love with my job.
Morning.
Good morning.
Good morning, Owen.
Good morning, Owen.
Okay, all right, I'm gonna do a quick walk around. If you can stand by the door and just let me know
when. Don't worry, the minute I see someone who looks like she owns the place, I'll call you.
What would I do without you?
Hey, Carl, give me a hand with it. Just over by the back.
Right to the back. Yeah. Watch that cart there, okay? What, these ones too?
Hi.
Hi.
Hi, look out!
Oh,
I am so sorry. Here. Yeah, I guess it's true what they say about it's bad luck to walk under ladders, huh?
What?
Although technically you walk past and this is a lift, not a ladder. Let me help you with that. Here, let me get that for you.
Stop!
Okay, but they are ladder adjacent.
Stop talking!
Okay. Ms. Masters, are you all right?
Yes, I'm fine.
I'm so sorry about this.
It's okay, it wasn't your fault.
Sure it was. I'm the one who hired him. Look, I am really very sorry. I'm more than happy to pay for the cleaning, Miss Masters, the store manager.
No, that won't be necessary, Mr.
Stone. Kurt Stone. Nice to meet you. You were supposed to finish this job yesterday. I know. I'm sorry. My other job went over. And Kurt, yesterday. I know. I apologize.
Hey, it's me. I need you to do me a favor. Right. Pull a size 2 in style 1375.
Look, Henry, I promise I will have it done by the end of the day. You're going to love it. Look, I appreciate your artistic eye, but a deadline is a deadline. And now this. Come on, Hank, buddy, it's me. Kurt,
It's nothing personal. This is our busiest time of year, and I need someone I can count on.
You know what? Just do your best and call me as soon as you have it, okay? It's an emergency. Thank you.
I know, but it's like less than a month until Christmas.
Look, as service director, I'm gonna have to let you go. But if Ms. Masters sees it differently, well, that's up to her.
Holly?
Christina, the sleigh has landed.
That's just great. Okay, I'm on my way.
Ms. Masters, I can...
Look, I'm sorry. Henry is right. It's his responsibility, so it's his decision. Whatever he thinks is best. Sorry.
I'm sorry, buddy.
So good. And I hold you all responsible for that. Nicely done. Nicely done. Every single day. I have so much appreciation for the job you do.
Hello.
Oh, you must be Christina.
Hello, Ms. McDougal.
Victoria, please. I'm so sorry I haven't been here to see you sooner.
I'm sorry I didn't greet you at the door. I had a little accident.
I like it. Maybe we can put that kind of thing in our new spring line. Seriously, accidents happen. It's how we handle them that makes the difference, don't you think?
Yes.
I'd like you to gather all the managers together for me. This won't take long, but I have an important announcement to make.
An announcement?
Yes, and I think people should hear it from me.
Of course.
Good morning, Ms. McDougal.
Oh, Henry.
It's wonderful to see you.
How long has it been?
Too long. How about a tour? See what we've done to the old place.
I would love that. Thank you. Shall we say 20 minutes on the third floor?
See you then.
Great.
I trust you had a great flight.
Oh, it's just always good coming home.
An announcement. That sounds ominous. She's gonna close the store. Is she gonna fire everybody?
No, not everybody. Just you, Holly. Don't panic. Let's not jump to conclusions. All right, you gather the troops and I'll meet you upstairs after I change my dress.
Thank you all for joining me this morning. As I'm sure you know, McDougal's is going international. We will be having our grand opening in Paris, France in the new year. Unfortunately, the man that I had chosen to manage that store has had a situation arise, and, well, the job is now open. You all know that I like to promote from within, so I'll be looking among you for someone who is adventurous, experienced, and would excel in the job. So give it a thought, and if you're interested, come and talk to me. I will be in town until we unveil our 25th annual Christmas display. Can't wait to see it. Thanks, everybody, and just make it a great day at McDougal's.
Thank you.
Paris?
It's like Victoria McDougal brought an early Christmas present just for you. I don't have the job yet.
But you're the store manager. You're the obvious choice.
Apparently not if Victoria is taking applications.
She's probably just doing that for appearances. Who else would she pick?
What about you?
Okay, let's be serious. I've been an assistant manager for a year. I think I need a little more time. And you know everything there is to know about Paris.
Hardly.
Your phone?
But it was magical being there. I felt like I was home. But that's not enough. I have to really impress her.
Have you seen last month's sales figures? I'm going to bet she's already impressed.
Look.
You didn't become manager of an entire department store by luck. This job is yours. All you need to do is go and get it.
My bow always ends up lopsided.
Okay, come here, let me help. You know, I began in gift wrap.
Really?
Mm-hmm. It was my very first job. And that's a perfect job.
Thank you, Ms. McDougal. Mm-hmm.
Victoria, may I speak with you for a minute?
Sure.
In private?
Yes. Let's walk. Oh, this place brings back so many wonderful memories.
I guess you never forget your first store.
Yeah. Yeah. So are you originally from the area?
Florida, but I moved here for the job.
Oh. I admire somebody who can pull up stakes in order to pursue their career. Of course, Paris is a lot farther than Florida.
Was I that obvious?
Say that I recognize ambition. That's what helped me build the largest department store chain in the Midwest. Now, this might be my very favorite part of the story.
25 years is very impressive.
Mm-hmm. Well, it was my very first promotional idea. See, a lot of stores did displays, but I thought, what if we had one display that stays closed until a couple days before Christmas?
It's brilliant. It gives our customers a reason to come back here for last-minute shopping.
And I'm told that half the state turns out to see it. I'm so glad we've kept it alive. I'd like to see your display.
No. It's a work in progress. I don't want you to see it until it's completely finished.
Oh, well, I certainly share your passion for it. It's that kind of spirit that we need in Paris.
I studied in Paris for a year, and I've always wanted to go back. Et je parle français. I would love to be considered for that job.
Oh. Well, I know that your store numbers are very good, but I want to know what you're like as a person. I want to see how you deal with the crew and with the customers.
I pride myself on my customer service skills. Bien sûr.
You don't have to keep doing that.
Okay, I'll stop. I'm just excited.
I understand. The thing is, this is important for me too, and I have a lot at stake. So I need to make very sure that I make the right choice.
Of course.
So this would be a very good place for you to start. Wow me.
I just heard everything. She's basically handing you the job.
No, she said I have to wow her.
Okay, so when she gets a look at this year's Christmas display, she'll be wowed, right?
I'm not so sure about that.
Oh.
Yeah.
We have to have this display ready to unveil in 2 weeks. Shouldn't you have started something already?
That's just it. I've got nothing to start.
What do you mean?
I mean, I have absolutely no good ideas for this year's display.
Nothing?
I've been racking my brain, but it's the 25th annual display. It has to be just right.
And Victoria McDougal wants me wowed.
Yeah. Wow. Yeah, hey, I'm just doing the walk around on two. I'll see you tomorrow.
Oh no, we're too late now. Like, he's gone.
Don't worry. Santa will be back tomorrow.
But I need to talk to him now.
Cooper has a special wish. I'm afraid it couldn't wait.
Ah, I see. Well, Cooper, as it happens, I am very good friends with Santa Claus. So why don't you tell me your wish and I'll pass it along to him?
I don't know.
I think you can trust this lady, Cooper.
I guess so.
So what do you want Santa to bring you? A bicycle? A new game system?
No, I don't want any toys. I just want my best friend back.
Who's your best friend?
My dad.
Oh.
He hasn't been himself in a while. I just want him to be happy.
Well, Cooper, that is an excellent wish. In fact, I think it's the best one I've ever heard.
Really?
And I will pass it along to Santa personally.
Shake on it.
Okay.
Now, remember, Cooper, Santa hears a lot of wishes. You can't make them all come true.
But you're his friend, he'll listen to you, right? If you ask him, he'll make my wish happen, won't he? Dad!
Hey, bud.
This way he knows Santa Claus personally!
Well, isn't that something?
She's gonna help make my wishes come true!
Okay, come on, Cooper. It's time to go.
Well, thank you again.
Merry Christmas!
Merry Christmas, Cooper.
Yeah. Merry Christmas.
How about a Hawaiian Christmas display? Elves in grass skirts and Santa on a surfboard. What? I'm trying here, come on.
I know, I'm sorry. I'm not being much help, am I?
Oh, it's fine. We've got 2 weeks to design and build a famous McDougal's Christmas display.
25th annual.
25th annual, yeah.
But don't let it bother you.
I'm sorry. I had something happen today that I can't get out of my head.
You want to share?
I had to fire somebody. Well, technically Henry did, but I could have stopped it, and I didn't.
Okay, so you've had to fire people before, right?
Yeah, it's never an easy thing to do.
So how's this one any different?
I don't know. He just seemed...
Wait, it was a he?
Yeah, Kurt Stone.
Good lucky.
I guess so.
And you fired him? No wonder you don't have a boyfriend.
And he has this really cute little boy named Cooper who came to see Santa today. You know what he wanted?
Stocks and bonds.
He wanted his dad to be happy.
The dad you fired?
You're not helping!
Chris, I'm sorry. I'm sorry about this guy and his kid, but it's not your problem, okay? You said it so yourself. This time of year is about business.
I guess you're right.
I know I'm right. You've got much more important things to worry about. Outer space.
What?
Santa in space. Reindeers with lasers shooting out of their antlers. What? Too much?
Well, we certainly don't think your husband has two left feet. We will happily exchange these, of course, and I would like to give you 10% off your next purchase. She'll take care of you. This is Christina. Go ahead.
This is security. We have a situation at Santa's workshop.
I'm on my way. Now what?
You want a candy cane?
No, I don't want a candy cane. I want to talk to Santa Claus.
Owen? Is everything... okay?
The boy jumped the line to see Santa.
You lied to me.
What?
You said you knew Santa, and you promised you would talk to him about my wish.
I didn't exactly promise.
Well, we shook on it.
I know.
You fired my dad. It's not what I wished for.
Well, you know, I wasn't the one who fired him. But he was let go. But it was before you made your wish, so there wasn't anything that Santa could do about it.
He could do anything. He's Santa Claus.
Who are you here with, sweetie?
No one.
Well, you came to the store alone?
Well, I was supposed to meet Nan after school for the ride home, but I didn't want to miss Santa, so I took the bus.
All by yourself?
I'm 6 years old.
Got his voicemail.
Told you, Dad never answers his phone at work.
What about your mom?
She lives in Australia now. She and my dad are divorced.
Hi, you've reached Kurt Stone. Leave me a message after the tone.
Yes. Hi. This is Christina Masters. We met yesterday at McDougal's.
I just want you to know that your son Cooper is safe. He's here with me, and I will bring him home. So please call me when you get the message. Thanks. You know, he's probably worried sick about you.
I know. He worries a lot. Do you have kids?
No.
Are you married?
No.
How come?
You ask a lot of questions.
Everybody says that.
Come on, let's get you home.
Uh-uh.
Why not?
Because I came here to talk to Santa, and I'm not leaving until I do.
Can't you just put him in a cab or something?
I can't do that. Holly, he's six. But you never leave the store during the workday.
I won't be gone long. Just cover for me, all right?
All right. But...
But what?
Is there something you're not telling me? What's that supposed to mean?
Leaving work early? This isn't like you.
Well, I don't think Santa's gonna help me.
What makes you say that, Cooper?
Because I told him I wish upon my dad. And he asked me if I wanted a bike.
I'll be back in an hour.
Oh. You asked me that already, but...
Well,
that's just something I don't want to do right now.
Do you have a boyfriend?
No.
Why not?
I don't have time for a boyfriend.
How much time does it take?
Well, more time than I have right now. I'm very busy at work.
I'm busy too, but I have a girlfriend.
You do?
Uh-huh, Kyla. She's in my class at school.
Really? And what's Kyla like?
She's kind of like you. She's nice and she smells good.
Thank you, Cooper.
Aw.
My dad's home.
Great.
Aren't you coming?
I don't think that'd be a great idea.
How come?
Well, I have to get back to the store. But I'm gonna make sure you get safe in there with your dad first, before I go.
See you, I guess.
Bye, Cooper. Oh, come on. Oh, not the battery again. I was gonna change it.
Didn't have time for that?
Ha ha. I just have to call a tow. Maybe not. My phone battery's dead. I didn't charge it this morning.
But you didn't have time for that, huh?
You know, I really need life advice from a six-year-old.
Hey, my dad could fix your car. He can fix anything.
Oh, I wouldn't want to impose on your father's time. But, do you think you'd let me call a tow truck from inside?
Sure, why not?
Yeah, why not?
Dad!
Cooper!
Hi, Dad.
Just can't go off on your own without letting us know. You know that.
I had to see Santa. It was an emergency.
Oh, it was... Hey, I got your message. Thanks. I tried to call you back, but there was no answer.
I had some phone trouble.
Cooper!
Hi, Nana.
Oh, we were so worried about you.
I was okay. I was with Christina.
Oh, yes. You're the one who fired my son.
Well, I didn't exactly fire him.
Technically true, but you didn't stop me from being fired either.
It's not quite the same thing.
Yeah, close enough.
Cooper, come on, let's check your schoolwork.
Nana.
Now.
Thanks, Christina. I hope I get to see you again if you have the time.
Cooper,
I'd make the time.
I think we need to stop bothering this nice lady with any more visits. Sorry for the trouble.
It wasn't any trouble, really.
Yeah, it was not, Christine. This car won't start.
Cooper, come on. I have cookies for you.
Go see Nana.
If I could just use your phone, I'll call a tow truck.
Oh, yeah, you should. Do you have any idea what the trouble is?
I think it's the battery. It won't start.
Oh, well, let me just help you give you a jump.
Oh, no, I don't want to bother you.
You brought my son home. It's the least I can do. You know, unless there's some company policy about accepting help from ex-employees, then I... Please. there's a charger in here someplace.
You're an artist.
Yeah.
You paint more than just walls, huh?
I needed the job. It wasn't always like this. I had a pretty good startup going last year, but then, yes, things happen, so.
Look, about yesterday,
Don't worry about it.
No, I just want to explain.
It's okay,
no,
I understand.
I
get it. If you didn't respect Henry's decision, you wouldn't have been a good boss, so.
Yeah, it was nothing personal. It was just...
Just business.
Right. Yeah. Business. What's this one gonna be?
Yeah, I don't know yet. I'm still waiting for inspiration, I guess.
This is really beautiful.
Oh, thanks.
Have you ever had a gallery show or anything?
No.
Why not? You're really, really talented.
Well, thanks, but they're not for show. They're just for me.
Yeah, but people would probably love to buy these.
Oh!
Sorry.
Well, not everything's about business, right?
Right.
Let's go start your car.
Okay.
It really came down today,
snowing.
Huh? Yeah, Cooper will be happy, though. I promised him I'd help him build a snowman.
He's really a great little kid.
Thanks. Yeah, I wish I could hang out with him more. Mom moved in with us last year, and so she could help out, and she's been great, but, you know.
So you from here originally?
Born and raised. I take it you're not.
Not what?
From here.
What makes you say that?
Well, you just don't strike me that way. You know, plus you've got a Eiffel Tower hanging from your mirror.
And what's wrong with that?
With the snowy roads we have right now, that's a vision hazard, ma'am.
Well, I happen to like it, thank you very much. But you're right. I moved here from Florida for the job.
Ah, nice. So what else do you do, other than looking around your Eiffel Tower?
Right now? Nothing but work, I guess.
Nothing but work?
Yeah, it's Christmas at the store, so we're really busy, and I'm up for a big promotion right now at work, so I'm trying to, you know, just focus. You know, as much as I can, just, you know, on work.
Got it. No fun. Give it a go.
Oh. Thank you so much.
No problem. Yeah, anyway, I guess I'll see you around.
Look. Let me talk to Henry.
Please don't, while I have a little bit of pride left. And seriously, thanks for bringing Cooper home.
Tell him I said goodbye?
Do you mind if I tell him see you later instead? He has a bit of a hard time with goodbyes.
I wouldn't mind at all.
See you later.
the Kurt you fired?
Well, I didn't fire him. I mean, you know, Henry fired him.
Technically.
Oh, you should see his paintings, though. I mean, he has a real eye for detail, you know? You can almost feel the emotion just jumping off the canvas.
Where did you see his paintings?
In his garage.
Wait, why were you in his garage?
To get his jumper cables, but that's another story.
Okay, well, at least tell me you've come up with an idea for the window display.
I'm working on it.
Christina, this is our busiest season.
I know.
So
I know.
Really need my manager around.
I'm sorry, Holly. I won't abandon you again. I promise.
Thank you. Now, I have your list of things to do here, and...
Lunch with Victoria McDougal?
Uh-huh. She won't tell me what it's about, but she said it's important.
Paris?
So there I was, surrounded by all my poster boards, trying to sell a room of investors on my big dream. You know what they said?
Yes.
No. No, they told me that I was crazy, that opening a new department store was never going to work, and that I was wasting my time.
So what did you do?
Well, I went home, cried for about half an hour. Then I picked up my poster boards, and I scheduled some more meetings with other investors. And I tried again. I tried again and again and again.
But in the end, you finally got there.
I did. But you know, I've had to make some very hard choices along the way.
What kinds of hard choices?
Well, I had to give up a lot of things that I really cared about. I didn't have the time for anything or anyone that wasn't part of building the dream.
Well, I've always been told that success doesn't come without sacrifice.
You know, I'd be lying if I didn't tell you that on occasion, I've wondered about what might have been. It's why I wanted to talk to you today. I want you to understand the sacrifice you're making if you go to Paris.
I do.
And there's nothing holding you here? There's nobody you'll be leaving behind?
You said that McDougal's is your dream. Paris is mine. I fell in love with that city. It felt like home to me.
I understand that. You know, I've said that I need somebody that has strong promotional skills for this job. So, when do I get to see your Christmas display?
Very soon. I guarantee it will be ready in plenty of time for opening night.
I hope so, for your sake. Because if you really want this job in Paris, this has to be the greatest Christmas display in McDougal's history. Is there it?
Yes.
Hey, Ms. Masters. What's up?
Just, searching for inspiration.
Are you still having trouble?
How'd you know I was having trouble?
We're close to opening night, and there isn't even a candy cane in here.
I don't know what's wrong with me. I just can't seem to come up with anything special enough.
Well, we could always use last year's display. Most of it's stored out in the warehouse. You know the rules around here. You can't throw anything out.
No, the whole point of this display is that it's new every year. That's what brings people back to the store.
Well, all right. I'll leave you to it.
Henry, you've known Victoria McDougal a long time, right?
Longer than I'd care to admit.
What's she like, really? You know, I mean, let's say somebody made a mistake or fell short. Is she a forgiving person?
Victoria McDougal is probably the kindest, sweetest lady I've ever known in her personal life. But when it comes to business, well, look out.
Great. Thanks, Henry.
If you need anything, I'm here for you.
Christina?
We've got a problem.
That jewelry shipment from Spain, the one with the platinum snowflake charms, it's been held up at customs. They say it might be delayed until after the new year.
What are we supposed to do with snowflake charms in January?
Christina!
Cooper! What are you doing here?
Christmas shopping for Dad. But don't tell him it's supposed to be a surprise.
My lips are sealed.
Cooper, don't bother Christina. I'm sorry.
Oh, no, it's okay. I'm never too busy for Cooper. So, tell me, what are you going to get your dad for Christmas?
Some paintbrushes, you know, stuff like that.
Sounds perfect. Hey, tell you what, why don't you guys head up to the arts and crafts department, and I'll be up in a minute to help you.
It's not every day my favorite customer comes into the store.
Oh, I almost forgot. I made you something.
Cooper, it's beautiful.
Look, see, that's me in the car and that too. It's for your Christmas tree.
I love it. Thank you.
All right, come on, Cooper. We have a lot to do today.
Okay, see you over there. Now we can get my dad his old job back.
Sorry. Come on, you.
He's a cute kid, isn't he?
Yeah, adorable. Now, what about the snowflakes?
Call the customs broker back and let them figure it out. I'll be back in 10 minutes. Put that on my desk.
Seriously?
I promise.
Fine.
Did you find something yet?
Not yet. Cooper's very thorough. He has your sale clerk demonstrating every paintbrush on the shelf. If we're lucky, he'll choose one by Christmas.
He's a wonderful little boy. You must be very proud of him.
I adore him. Yeah, he works all morning on that decoration he gave you. In fact, you're all he's talked about since he met you. He really likes you. So does Kurt.
Look, Nana, it's got every color. Dan will be able to paint anything he wants, right, Christina?
Absolutely. Anything he wants.
I got $5. Is this enough?
This is exactly enough. Cooper, do you think your dad might come back to work for me?
No. Thank you.
Why not?
Well, for starters, I don't know the first thing about Christmas displays.
You don't have to. I've done enough for both of us. What I need from you is your artistic eye, the way you see things, your creativity.
My creativity? You mean my Christmas vision?
Exactly.
Uh-huh. Look, I see what you're doing, and it's very sweet, but as you can see, I already have a new job.
Yes, it looks very fulfilling.
You don't have to be sarcastic. Look, if you want to help, you can hand me that bag.
Kurt, this isn't charity. You've got a very special talent. And the truth is, I need your help. Please.
Look, I got to get this done. I don't want to be fired.
Fine. If you change your mind, you know where to find me.
And you know where to find me. Up a ladder.
Dad, is it just gonna be you and me and Nana for Christmas again this year?
Yeah, I guess so. Why?
No reason.
Can you pass me that last clip, please? Thank you.
Nana and I saw Christina today.
I know, Nana told me.
I like Christina. She passes my test.
You have a test?
Uh-huh. She's really nice and she smells good.
I would agree with that.
What do you think Christina's gonna do for Christmas this year?
I don't know.
She's not marrying you now. She might be lonely.
I'm sure Christina has somewhere to go for Christmas.
You don't know.
You ready?
Ready.
I think we're good. OK. Okay, countdown.
Three, two, one.
Whoa!
Not bad, huh?
You know who would like this?
Who?
Christina.
Nothing. I don't know, Mom. Maybe I've just lost it.
Or maybe you just need some fresh inspiration.
I stayed up all night working on a design for the display.
And? Nothing? But you said you had it figured out.
Yeah, I thought I did. I was wrong.
But the opening night is in 10 days.
We're gonna have to delay it.
But we've already sent out a press release. The invitations have been sent.
I am aware of that, Holly, but I don't know what else to do.
I heard you were hiring.
It.
All right. Yeah. Yeah, nice big open space. We can treat this as a canvas. Yeah. What do you want it to say?
How about something like, come buy stuff.
Really? Is that all Christmas means to you?
You don't have to make it sound so bad.
No, I
love Santa.
I love Santa.
I'm not Scrooge. Yes, for me, Christmas does mean business first, but it's my job.
Okay, well, in that case, we should just go see what's been done before.
No, but this has to be totally different.
Exactly. But in order to work on Christmas future, we need to go visit the ghosts of Christmas past. Oh, wow.
There's a lot to see, that's for sure. I bet there are things in here going back 80 years.
Wait, 80? I thought Victoria McDougal started the store 25 years ago.
She did. There was a store before that, and it wasn't always called McDougal's. It started out as a five and dime run by two brothers, the Smiths. And then it got bigger, and the Calloway family bought it.
What, Henry? Is that you?
Uh-huh. When I was a kid, I used to go to the Calloway department store every Christmas.
So cute. Who's the little girl?
Oh, just a friend. Anyways, the Calloways ran it for a while, and then it closed up. It sat empty for a long time before Victoria McDougal came along and decided she wanted to run a department store of her own. The rest is history. Well, this is all the Christmas stuff. Help yourselves. I'll be out back if you need me.
Perfect.
Thanks, Henry.
So, how does Christina Masters spend Christmas?
Me? Oh, I don't do anything special. I'm not that into it.
Really?
Well, Christmas wasn't that big a deal in our house. My parents owned a restaurant, and it was always busy during the holidays.
Anyway, by the time they got home, they were always so tired, they couldn't even wrap our presents, let alone decorate a tree.
Okay, okay. You win. The sad Christmas contest.
Come on, it wasn't that bad. Oh, this is cool. Okay, fine, I'll tell you. Every Christmas Eve, I get a big suite at a nice hotel, I order room service, and I watch old movies.
But that's why you're having trouble with the display, because you don't know what Christmas looks like.
I don't know what it looks like. I see it all day long here at the store.
That's different, that's sales. I'm talking about Christmas, you know? Oh, and I have just the guy to teach you. Come on, come on. M'lady.
The thing about finding the right tree is you have to imagine it in your living room all dressed up, right, Dad?
Uh-huh, that's right. And then you have to imagine you take that first look at it Christmas morning. Oh, does it take your breath away?
Actually, I'm having a hard time picturing having a Christmas tree in my living room at all.
Kidding.
I told you, Christmas is not that big a deal for me.
Yeah, bah humbug.
Then maybe we should get a tree for you two.
Ooh.
I'm good.
Yes, sir.
This is the one, Dad.
Okay.
All right, let's get it back to the store.
Oh, I didn't tell you, this one isn't for the store.
What?
Oh my, what a beautiful tree.
Yeah.
Hello, Christina. I didn't expect to see you.
I didn't expect to be here.
Christina can use a little bit of a refresher course on Christmas. Thought we could help.
Will you stay and decorate the tree with us, Christina?
Me?
It is part of the lesson plan.
Please stay.
Why not?
Yes!
I'll get the decorations.
Tree leveling 101. Okay, you got your gloves on, but you're going a little bit left.
Wait, my left?
What's the same left?
So just, I got this. Hang on.
Okay.
Okay, you got it. See? I told you.
No! Yeah, you got it.
Yeah, I almost had it.
These are a mess.
Let me help you, Coop. The trick is to go slowly, very carefully. And whatever you do, do not pull.
Oh. There. What do you think?
I think it's a perfect Christmas tree.
And when all else fails, call in the reserves.
Thank you, Grace. That was delicious.
Well, I'm afraid it was just leftovers. If someone had warned me you were coming.
Oh, please, Grace, it was wonderful. I don't remember the last time I ate something that didn't come from a bag.
Did you ask her yet, Dad?
Ask me what?
You have homework to do, right? We should,
I don't have any homework.
Well, I think we can find you some. Anyways, it's time for your bed anyways. Let's go.
I hope you say yes.
You will have to forgive my grandson. I'm afraid he is at the age where he says whatever comes into his head.
Here, let me help you with that.
No, you don't have to.
No, please, I want to. I don't think I've seen my kitchen since the Christmas rush started. It's a welcome change.
Kurt says you are very busy at the store.
Yes, that's why I was so glad he came back. We really need him at the store. You know, he's a very talented artist.
I just wish more people knew it.
He really doesn't let anyone see his paintings?
It wasn't always that way. It started around the time he and Cooper's mother broke up. It seems like he just lost all confidence in himself. Look, I want to apologize for what I said the other day. I know it wasn't your idea to fire my son.
No apologies necessary.
It's just that you are the first young woman that my son has brought home since his divorce, and I guess I'm just a little overprotective.
I wouldn't call it that. I'd call it, being his mom.
Hey, so, can I give you a lift home?
That'd be great. But we do have to make one stop on the way. How about this one?
Yeah, well, I guess it's a good starter tree.
I'll take it.
Look what Cooper said at dinner.
Oh, I was wondering about that.
Yeah, well, I guess it wouldn't be a very good father if I didn't at least, you know, ask his question.
All right. What's his question?
Well, Cooper was wondering, if maybe instead of your hotel room this Christmas, you might want to spend Christmas with us?
Kurt.
I know. I told him he was rushing things.
No, it's just I just can't make plans like that right now. I hope Cooper understands.
Oh, of course. He's six. Full of great ideas.
Better get this home.
You know what I was thinking, though? We could do the famous local landmarks, but in a Christmas theme.
Oh, I like that idea. We could do, like, City Hall, but wrapped up like a big Christmas
present. Oh, yeah, and I was thinking we could do the old fire hall, but instead of a horse-drawn wagon, we'd do it.
Reindeer.
That's what I'm saying. Exactly. See? What did I tell you? All you needed was a little Christmas inspiration.
I just hope that Victoria McDougal sees it that way.
Yeah. This, isn't only a Christmas display, is it?
Oh, I'm up for that promotion, so this might help seal the deal. That's all.
Ah, right. Big promotion.
And by the authority vested in me, I present this key to one of our own, Ms. Victoria McDougal.
Thank you, Mr. Mayor, for this wonderful honor. I am deeply touched. I am so proud to be from here. I remember when starting a new department store was a risk. But what is life without taking a chance or two along the way? With the help and encouragement of all the amazing people who call this their home, we have made McDougal's a success in the Midwest, and soon, around the world. Thank you. I look forward to seeing all of you at our big event, and we will unveil this year's Christmas display.
So, what are you going to do when the opening night comes and there's nothing to display?
We're going to be fine.
Christina?
Yes, Victoria.
A situation has come up. It's about Paris. You see, the board has appointed a new director, and he would like the name of my candidate by the end of the week. So, I'll need your designs right away.
Oh,
I'm about to go into a couple meetings, so how about this afternoon?
Today?
Yes. I'll be at my hotel by 3.
3 o'clock today.
Yes, that's perfect. I can't wait to see what you've come up with. Oh, Mayor.
Neither can I.
Emily, woke up with a temperature. He's been sniffling and sneezing all night.
Oh, buddy.
Yeah, my mom's at work, and obviously I can't leave.
But I need those sketches by this afternoon. Kurt, I'm gonna call you back.
Holly. Let me guess, do you need somebody to cover for you?
I know, I'm sorry, but it's an emergency.
Sure, no problem.
Thank you.
What do you say, Cooper?
Thanks, Christina. If I knew I was gonna get a spaceship every time, I'd be sick more often.
Just get better soon, okay?
We'll be downstairs if you need us.
Dad, did you ask her about Christmas yet?
We'll talk about that later.
But, Dad...
You play with your spaceship, but try to get some rest, all right? I love you.
Miss McDougal?
Oh, Holly, isn't it?
Yes. May I speak with you for a minute? It's kind of important. It's about Christina.
Oh, of course.
So, there's City Hall. And there's the bridge.
Kurt, these are perfect.
Oh, thank you. And my favorite, the old fire station.
With my reindeer.
Mm-hmm. Let me see what I... Oh, it is still snowing out there, so I should probably...
Oh, yes. Those up for thank you. You.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, how's the new one coming? Did you find any inspiration yet? Can I peek?
No, don't.
Oh.
Yeah, so I saw the pictures hanging in your apartment and the dangly mirror thing, and yeah, I figured you loved Paris, so.
It's beautiful.
Thanks. It's, you know, it's still a work in progress, but you inspired it. Look, I really hope that Victoria McDougal appreciates what she's getting.
I think she's gonna love your sketches.
I wasn't talking about that.
Kurt, I need to tell you something.
Tell me
hey, Dad, I'm thirsty. Can I have a juice?
We're just, okay.
I have to go.
No, Christina, wait, here. Yeah, well, first,
thank you. I hope you feel better really soon, Cooper.
Bye. What's the matter with Christina?
Coop. Sometimes you ask too many questions.
I love them.
You do?
I do. These are truly wonderful designs. Who's the artist?
Kurt Stone.
Well, he's a real find. But I'm sorry we won't be able to use them in the display.
But you just said that they were wonderful designs.
Oh, they are. They say everything about Christmas. They say nothing about McDougal's.
No, we have a sign. There's a big banner that says McDougal's 25th annual Christmas display.
I'm afraid you're missing the point. You see, McDougal's has a history. We honor that history every year with our Christmas display. Now, these are lovely, I will give you that. But they'd be good in any store in the country. They just won't do for mine. So now I guess we'll have to go back to last year's Christmas display.
What? But I thought that...
No, I simply cannot leave the display closed. I can't do that. So for the first time in 25 years, McDougal's will have to repeat their Christmas display.
Wait, Victoria, please. Be reasonable.
I think I have waited as long as I possibly can.
But people love this display. They look forward to it every year.
I know that. But I'm not going to put a generic Christmas display in my flagship store. So either it's last year's or it's nothing.
I'm so sorry, Victoria. I've really let you down.
You know, as I was saying to your assistant, Holly.
Wait, you talked to Holly?
She approached me today. We had a very interesting conversation. I told her I was hoping that you would wow me.
I heard what happened with Victoria and the display.
It was all my fault, Henry. I got distracted by other things. And I didn't focus on the job at hand. I still can't believe that Victoria wasn't willing to at least...
compromise? Victoria McDougal doesn't know the meaning of the word. Never has. Even when she was a little girl.
How long have you known her?
About this long.
That's Victoria?
We were 10. She looked into that window, her face lit up. She said, Henry, someday I'm gonna have a store of my own. And she did.
Was Victoria McDougal your first girlfriend?
Yep. We went steady all through high school.
Really?
And later, well, she didn't want to compromise.
Wait, she dumped you?
She would never have done that. It was my idea. I didn't want her to have to make the choice between me and her dream. So I broke it off.
You're who she meant when she said she had to give up a lot. You're still in love with her, aren't you?
I should head home.
Henry, may I borrow that photograph?
Sure, why?
Morning.
Morning.
Do you want a coffee or something?
Is there something you'd like to tell me? About Paris and Victoria?
Look. You're my boss, but you're also my friend.
So, what did you say to Victoria?
Well, what I really wanted to say was that I had been doing all my own work plus yours, and that it just wasn't fair.
I know I've been taking advantage of you, and I'm sorry.
Wait, I'm not finished. That's what I wanted to say. What I really said was that you're not only the best manager in the city, but you're also the best friend I've ever had. And that you'd be perfect for Paris.
Holly. Friends?
Always.
Good. Now let's go.
Huh?
We've got work to do. All right, everybody. You know what we're looking for. We've got 24 hours until the big unveiling. Let's do this. Yes, perfect. Thank you.
Santa's elves are working overtime tonight.
I snowflake these to go a little higher. Perfect. Rocking horse needs to go right over there.
Ho, ho, ho.
What are you doing here?
Oh, Henry called me, thought you could use an extra hand.
You know what? I think it's time that the rest of the world sees how good you are.
Yeah. Ooh, but I get to choose my weapon?
Whatever you want. Except that.
A very excited crowd has gathered here tonight inside McDougal's department store for the unveiling of their exciting new Christmas display, which nobody has seen before. Children of all ages are waiting to see what's in store for them behind that curtain.
There's
many two beats in there. Look at this, it's Christina. Hi, Christina.
Hi. Good luck. Good evening, everyone, and welcome to the 25th annual McDougal's Christmas display unveiling. Are you all ready to see what's in this year's display? Ladies and gentlemen, I have a very special Christmas surprise for you tonight. Please welcome the founder of McDougal's Department Stores, Ms. Victoria McDougal.
What's going on? You know how I feel about this year's display.
I think you'll be pleasantly surprised. And someone I admire very much once said, "What is life without taking a chance or two along the way?"
All right. Let's see what you've got.
And now, without further ado, let's start the countdown. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. The 25th annual McDougal's Christmas display. Let it snow.
Look at this!
I know!
Oh, ho, ho, ho! Welcome to Christmas at McDougal's.
Oh!
Merry Christmas, everyone.
It's beautiful.
Please, come on in.
Well, does this remind you of something special?
Merry Christmas.
I think it's time to welcome everybody to Christmas at McDougal's. You did good. You did it. We did it.
You like it?
Henry. I told you people would love your work. All you had to do was give them a chance to see it.
Thank you. Yeah, looks like Christmas is off to a great start.
Kurt, about the other day, I need to tell
Christina, excuse me, I'm so sorry. This must be the artist you told me about.
Yes, Victoria McDougal, Kurt Stone.
Pleasure to meet you.
The pleasure is mine. I really enjoyed your sketches that Christina showed me.
Oh, well, thank you.
He also painted and helped build this entire display.
Well, maybe we should talk about you doing some work at my other stores, if that interests you.
I'd be very interested. Thanks.
Good. We'll be in touch. Oh, Christina, I was going to wait until tomorrow to tell you this, but the job in Paris is yours.
It is.
I thought you'd be a little more excited about this.
Wow. Thank you. Thank you so much.
You're welcome. The only problem is that it has to start sooner than we thought. You'll be on the last flight out tomorrow night. Christmas Eve. I hope you don't have any plans.
No, nothing.
Good. Well, then, congratulations. We will talk about this in the morning. It was so nice to meet you, Mr. Stone.
And you.
A pleasure.
Merry Christmas. Yeah. So that was the big promotion you were talking about. Paris.
It's the company's first store in Europe. It's a huge, huge opportunity for me.
Yeah. No, that's terrific.
It's everything I've been working for.
Yeah. I'm just worried about how I'm going to explain this to Cooper.
I already know.
Cooper, we'll talk about this at home.
Thought you liked me.
Cooper!
Mom, come.
Where could he have gone?
Mom, I don't. Can you go that way? I'll check.
Cooper! Cooper?
Go away.
Hi.
I'm not talking to you. I was looking for Santa.
Cooper, you got your wish. Looks like your dad's gonna have a new job doing paintings for our stores. So he'll be able to spend lots more time with you.
Yeah, but now I have a new wish.
And what's that?
I wish you weren't going to stupid Paris, and I wish you would stay with us for Christmas and for always.
Cooper, let me try to explain something to you. Sometimes, when you're all grown up, you have to make choices in your life. Sometimes they're really hard choices, but you still have to make them.
Yeah, but how do you know which one to make?
Well, you don't. That's just part of life. Does that make sense?
I guess so. I just wish you chose my dad and me.
He'll be okay. I told you he doesn't like goodbyes. Neither do I.
Kurt.
So I guess we'll just say see you later. Bye.
Last-minute Christmas rush is on. Tonight is Christmas Eve, so you know the stores are going to be busy with lots of folks just brimming with holiday spirit.
I still can't believe this is happening.
Well, you definitely impressed Victoria. When I suggested you take over managing the store, she couldn't say yes fast enough.
I don't know how to thank you for this.
Just make me proud. Oh, and a little bit of advice. Start thinking about next year's Christmas display now. Better get going. Airport's gonna be packed tonight.
Have you talked to Kurt?
No.
You're just going to leave it like this?
Made my choice, Holly. That's all there is to it.
I'm going to miss you.
You too.
Merry Christmas.
Merry Christmas.
Hi, welcome to McDougal's.
I saw you be gone by now.
I'm on my way. I just want to thank you again and drop these off for Cooper and Grace and you.
You didn't have to do this.
Yes, I did.
Well, in that case...
No. Please don't tell Cooper I'm here. I have to go.
I was going to wrap it, but now...
It's beautiful. I love it.
Although I guess you don't need any more, huh? Because you'll be looking at the real thing.
Right.
I guess I should... I'll ship it to you.
Great. Okay. Thank you. I put it up as soon as after, you know, you... Please understand. Paris is special for me. It's just always felt like home, and I have to go. Merry Christmas.
Merry Christmas.
Dad?
Oh, it's just a friend.
Okay.
Airport, miss?
Can you load these into the car for us, please?
Victoria.
Oh, hi, how nice to see you. I thought you'd be relaxing in the first class lounge by now.
Hi.
Are you two going somewhere?
St. Martin. Victoria has a little place there.
We have a lot of catching up to do.
You know, Christina, thanks to you, we found each other again.
Your display taught me a lot of things that I'd forgotten. Things that are really important. You know, you give up a lot when you're trying to find success. And then when you do find it, you realize what you gave up was something you never wanted to lose.
Victoria, I came by to properly thank you for this opportunity.
You earned it.
And there's one more thing.
Cooper!
I knew Santa wouldn't let me down! Nana, guess who it is? I got my wish!
Hey, what's...
I have a proposition for you. I'm looking for a painter.
Okay, what's the job?
Well, he'd have to come with me to Paris for 2 weeks to help design the store while I train a new manager. It's all part of my new position as corporate manager at McDougal's, which is based right here.
Is a long-term contract?
That's very negotiable.
But you wanted to live in Paris because it felt like home to you.
I'm thrilled about the upcoming trip to Paris for business. I found my real home right here with you.
Now it is beginning to look a lot like Christmas.
Dad! What?
So this is what Christmas looks like.
What are you doing here? You put it on my beard. I think you get one present tonight, right? You have to roll one. Oh my God, yeah.
That one?
Thank you.
Do I get one?
Where's mine?
Yes.
Excuse me.
I think that's 6 months ago,
He
accidentally broke up her engagement.
I don't need your help. Done quite enough already.
Now, to make it up to her, he'll pretend to be...
We are engaged.
...her fiancé.
That's wonderful!
When's the wedding?
When calls the hearts, Daniel Lissing.
Everywhere I look, I see Christmas and I see you, and I love it.
A December Bride premieres tomorrow at 8. Part of Countdown to Christmas on...